Hello students, today we are going to start with the first chapter, the third level from your book Vistas, and it has been written by Jack Finney. Jack Finney was born on 2nd October 1911 and lived till November 14, 1995. He was an American author. His best known works are science fiction and thrillers, including The Body Snatchers and Time and Again. The Third Level by Jack Finney is about harsh realities of war. War has irreversible consequences, thus leading people in a state of fear and insecurity. It is also about modern day problems and how man tends to escape from reality by various means. People find it hard to make peace with unpleasant things they come across in life. The story brings out a common man's craving for peace and security and dwells on the theme of escapism. Not only as a psychological refuge from the grim realities of the present day world, but also as a desire to stay with the past or to keep the past alive in the complexities of the present. Charlie, the protagonist, hallucinates and reaches the third level of the Grand Central Station, which only has two levels in real. He uses the third level to escape from the unpleasant life of New York to the pleasant life of Galesburg, Illinois. Setting of the story. The story is set in New York, Grand Central Station, 1950s, and Galesburg, Illinois, 1890s. It moves simultaneously between New York in 1950 and 1890s. Now the characters in the story. Charlie, the protagonist, a 31-year-old guy who is highly imaginative and sensitive. He is mentally exhausted from the pressures of his job. He is the true representative of the modern man who lead a life of stress, insecurity, fear and worries and wants to run away from reality. Louisa is Charlie's wife. She is loving and caring towards her husband. However, she is a simple lady and it is not difficult to take her in. Sam Wiener is Charlie's friend. He is a psychiatrist by profession. He is a typical city guy. When Charlie shares his visiting the third level, he correctly diagnoses the ailment of his friend. The first place mentioned in the story is Grand Central Station. Grand Central Station is a railway station in New York. It has two levels where the commuters take train to different stations. At one level, one can find intercity trains, long distance trains plying between the cities. And on the other level, one can board intra-city trains, trains plying within the city. No third level was ever built. So, there is a controversial third level in the story from where one can take train to an idyllic place in 1894. At this level, the ambience of the station is that of 1894. Everything is in the style of 1890s, including the people, their attire, locomotive, currency being used, newspaper and magazines. Second place mentioned in the story is Galesburg, Illinois. Galesburg, Illinois is still a wonderful town with big old frame houses, huge lawns and tremendous trees. In 1894, it reflected a world of romance, freeness and repose. Summer evenings were twice as long. People sat out in their lawns, the men smoked cigars and talked quickly. The women sat in leisure, waving palm leaf fans. It means people had lived in peace and harmony and had a lot of leisure time. It was a peaceful world. Charlie wanted to go back there to escape from insecurities, fear, war, worry, and tensions of the modern world. There is mention about three presidents of America: President Roosevelt, President Cleveland, President James Garfield. Now, the story. The story begins in a mock serious manner. Everyone knows that there are only two levels at Grand Central Station in New York. However, Charlie, a dweller of the city, not only believed in the existence of this hypothetical third level, but also claimed to have been there in the third level. So, Charlie visited a psychiatrist friend to discuss about his problem. But his friend said that it was a daydream wish fulfillment and rationalized Charlie's psychology by saying that the modern world is full of insecurities, fear, worry, and war. Everybody wants to escape to some temporary refuge from reality. So he also wanted to escape and had created an imaginary third level. Charlie was fond of stamp collection, but his psychiatrist friend called it a manifestation of temporary refuge. But Charlie did not agree with this claim of his friend. His grandfather was a stamp collector, yet he was a happy man. And he never ran away from any reality, as things were quite nice in his time. Another stamp collector was President Roosevelt, the American president who won the World War II. Then Charlie explained what exactly happened to him one night. He described that he worked late at the office, so he was in a hurry to be at his apartment. He decided to take the subway from Grand Central Station because it was faster than the bus, and he got lost there. The fast-growing Grand Central Station at times seemed to be a maze to Charlie. He lost his way a couple of times earlier too, while taking the subway. Once he entered the lobby of Roosevelt Hotel, while the other time he emerged at an office building that was 3 blocks away. But this time, when he lost his way, something unique happened. He visited third level. Charlie kept on walking along the quiet corridor, which went turning left and slanting downward, till he reached an architecturally old station that was completely different from the two familiar levels. Charlie saw a 100-year-old world and people there. The antiquated small room with fewer ticket counters and train gates, a wooden information booth, flickering open flame gas lights and brass spittoons, string watches and so on reminded him of the architecture of the 1890s. He found that people were dressed in outmoded outfits and men had funny handlebar, mustache and sideburns. The whole setting was in contrast to the modern times. Charlie began to doubt that he had become part of the old world. Yet, he still did not know which year it was. But when he also noticed that the date on the newspaper, The World, was printed June 11, 1894, with a piece of news of President Cleveland, Charlie was greatly amazed and he thought of living there, a world behind his time, because the 1894 world was more peaceful, innocent and secure. He tried to get 2 rail tickets to his hometown's Galesburg, where he had spent his childhood, one for his wife indeed. But he failed to get the tickets, because when he took out his money to pay the fare, the clerk at the ticket counter suspected him and his notes, as the currency did not match with the currency of that time. He thought that Charlie was attempting to fool him and threatened to hand him over to the police. Seeing that there was nothing good about police and jail in the 100-year-old Galesburg, Charlie ran away and got out of the third level and finally reached the present world and got home. Charlie had always wanted to travel to Galesburg with his wife Louisa. In his mind, it was a wonderful town, still with big old frame houses, huge lawns and tremendous trees. It was a place with long and pleasant summer evenings, and where people had ample of time. So the next day during lunch, he exchanged $300 for old-style bills, amounting to some 200 only. The loss did not bother him much, as he believed that in Galesburg, everything would be cheaper and he could manage even with a small amount. But he could never again find the corridor leading to the third level. His wife Louisa was worried after knowing all this and asked him not to look for the third level any further. Suddenly, Charlie realized that his friend Sam Winner was nowhere to be found. So, he and his wife kept looking for him in the weekends. Sam was the one with whom Charlie used to share his ideas about Galesburg. Stamp collection was Charlie's favorite pastime. Philately is not just stamp collection, but a broad term including the study of stamps, postal history, and other related items. At that time, when a new stamp was issued, stamp collectors bought some of them on the first day and mailed a blank paper to themselves and then retained that unopened letter with the date on the postmark. Charlie had inherited this hobby and collection from his grandfather. One day, while fidgeting with his stamp collection, Charlie came across a letter that was not there earlier. The envelope was sent on July 18, 1894 to Charlie's grandfather in Galesburg and was addressed to Charlie. The postmark showed the picture of President Garfield. When Charlie opened it, the paper inside was not expectedly blank. The letter read that Sam had reached Galesburg and was having whale of a time there. He also invited Charlie and Louisa to Galesburg. When Charlie went to the stamp and coin store, he was apprised of Sam's exchanging $800 for old currency bills to establish his business of hayfeed and grain in Galesburg. The letter was written by Sam Pinner, who was Charlie's psychiatrist. So, Sam's letter from Galesburg to Charlie in the 20th century leaves everyone mystified. Charlie found the letter among the first day covers of his grandfather's collection. Someone had mailed it to his grandfather at his house in Galesburg. The address on the envelope said so, but the paper inside the envelope was not blank. Generally, the first day covers have blank papers in them. But Charlie found a letter written to him by Sam in which he informed that he had reached the third level. The first possibility is Sam was influenced by Charlie's glowing description of Galesburg and he got transported to the peaceful past through the medium of imagination because of his inability to cope up with the harsh realities of life. So through this letter, Sam suggested Charlie and Louisa to keep looking for the third level. Secondly, the question could be raised about the authenticity of the letter. Was the letter written by Sam or was it written by Charlie himself? It is rather much astonishing how such a letter was never noticed earlier and how Sam disappeared. And nobody knew about his whereabouts, but Charlie had doubt about Sam's presence in Galesburg. If Charlie could speak about his journey in the third level, which was unknown to others, so his possibility of writing the letter in the name of Sam could not be ruled out. The introductory part of the letter seemed to be a projection of Charlie's waking dream wish fulfillment. It confirmed his belief in the existence of the third level. So Sam's letter to Charlie was another product of his own imagination. Thus, the letter in the story appeared to be a strange mixture of the real and the fantasy, and the author has made a very clever use of it so that it boggles the reader's mind. Here we have completed with the first chapter, the third level. Hope you have understood it well.